20 goons and a ice cream whip, triple scoop. I got 3 strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna play me, no conversation, ain't got time for no debate.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Arizona Cardinals. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line.
Ready, 5-9.
Switch.
Check. Over.
This is Alvin Kamara, who made the Pro Bowl in each of his first 2 NFL seasons. Give him 3 there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
On 2nd and 7, Breeze. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. Following the penalty, it's Kamara. Corey Peters there to bring him down.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now, we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
On 2nd down, Kamara. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It'll be a Saints 1st down on a pickup of 13.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it could be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Byron Murphy, the rookie from Washington. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Cardinals. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And the Cardinals will go up 7-0. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 1st quarter.
Ready?
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
but they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, it didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Throwing on second and eight, Breeze, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
Now Breeze on third down. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Back deep, the former star in nearby LSU, Patrick Peterson. This is fielded at the 7. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Cards will take over, 1st and 10. Murray and the Cardinals with a 1st and 10 at their own 17-yard line. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. A Cardinal first down on a gain of 13. First down, Murray. And this one caught by Max Williams. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
To throw again on 2nd down. Murray, he dumps it off to Dre. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and just like that, it's 3rd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Murray going to try to throw on 3rd down. And able to find Kirk complete. And he's got the 1st down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 7 yards on the quick slant and a 1st down. Murray going to lead his guys up 1st and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Throwing on 1st down is Murray. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Justin Pugh, the left guard that time with a flag. They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Again, they'll throw with Murray. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down. Throwing again, Murray. Going deep for Hopkins. And that'll be incomplete.
Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Murray with a third and long. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
An absolute zero surprise that that one was incomplete, huh? I mean, truthfully, how many OCs have we seen with third and 20 on their play sheet and go, oh, I've got the exact play to dial up?
Now, that's just a head scratching down when you're facing a third and 20. Tried to complete it, couldn't get it done. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. He'll field this at the five. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Saints will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? But it definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession as they've got it with a second down and two coming up. The tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
Sammy. Check. Check. Hot.
Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. Throw on third and two. And they're already in the red zone. The 18-yard line is where they take over. That interception sets them up beautifully, already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
After the turnover, here's Murray. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals push further out in front. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And a pretty slick return there as he's up just shy of the 45-yard line.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams...
And that's going to be intercepted. The all-pro corner, Patrick Peterson. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Let's go!
ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, they could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But this is the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking. Usually the best way to maintain control.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Now Murray throwing on 2nd down. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
They went with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave them trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Throwing is Murray on 3rd down. Open man is Kirk, complete. And he'll get this up near midfield, but that's still a few yards shy of the 1st down. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to 4th down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still 2nd quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Now Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up 3rd. The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on 3rd down. Shotgun now for Breeze. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 10 yards, good for his Saints, 1st down.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen, because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and this is what we saw there, a nice pickup for a 1st down.
Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. That's their 2nd, so they'll have 1 remaining here in this 2nd quarter. We'll be right back. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Now, fellas, break it down. Under. He's checking crap.
Breeze to throw again. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 17 there, and a New Orleans 1st down. 2 minutes to play, 1st half. It's 14-0. Coming up at half about time. We remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
They'll pass complete here to Sanders. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara, and he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Ready! 5-8! 5-8! 20 seconds!
On first down, Breeze. And that'll be incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught, they've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Here's Breeze. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range, so now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Got a man, he finds Sanders. 10 yards, good for his Saints, first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
A first opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. They've got a first and 10 at the 11. Now Breeze. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. He was trying to hit Thomas that time, but it'll be second down.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
5-9. Mach 43. Mach 43.
Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Looking for Thomas. He's got it. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. His 9th touchdown of the season. As they are now on the board here in the first half. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camp. Do you remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room? This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, a full half to be played. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take
25. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Cards with a lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. They've gone to the second quarter in Buffalo. And an impressive display by the Eagles. They continue to pour it on, scoring again. And we'll be sure to keep an eye on that one as we go along here. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Kenyon Drake. His sixth touchdown of the season. Here the Cardinals push further out in front. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation, but I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game to be in on second half no matter what. With his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And their halftime hole now even deeper. They need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Now Kamara. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Following the penalty, it's Murray. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Ready.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run.
We all knew.
To throw, it's Breeze. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. Throwing now is Breeze. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 19.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Ready? So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On the ground, Kamara. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. To throw is Breeze. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
You got to be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? From the gun, it's Breeze. And he's got it. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Emmanuel Sanders. His third touchdown now on the year as his guys are back within a single score. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. Lux with the extra point, and they're back with it, a touchdown at 21-14. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Check. Crunch. Crunch. Crunch.
First down, Murray. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. To throw again, second and 10. Airing this one out for Fitzgerald. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play, and guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they begin this drive in very precarious field position inside their own five.
And remember, this is a defense that's already scored once in this game, so you've got to really take care and make sure that you're blocking these guys to try and wedge the ball out from the shadow of your own end zone.
First and 10 at the 13-yard line.
So a little more space to work with here from the 13 on first and 10. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Drew Brees, 6 fourth quarter comebacks a season ago, and that led the NFL. He'll try to deliver another one. Now a first.
first down carry. It's Kamara. And he takes this across the 15 to the 17. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Charles, this one not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range. And guess what? They've got a shot.
On the ground, this is Kamara. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
The Saints on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll run here. It's Murray. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Ready? Yellow lady?
Watch the curl. Watch the curl.
Kill, kill.
Jim, Jim, Jim.
You're good, you're good. My four, ready.
Breeze now on first down. It's caught by Sanders. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on second and 14. Breeze looking long for Thomas. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
Ready. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now Breeze. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 39. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. He's on quite the interception run. He had two last week, another one here. Remember, he's not a DB, he's a linebacker.
But how many of those linebackers started as DBs and pumped themselves up into being linebackers? So the ball skills are the same, right? The coverage skills and responsibilities are the same. And he is paying it off in a big, big way.
They'll start the drive with Drake. Tackled there by Alex Anzalone. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Second down, here's Murray. That's going to be caught by Kirk. It'll be an Arizona first down on a gain of 17. Well, that's a familiar connection right there. Christian Kirk was in the same class as Kyler Murray at Texas A&M. They played together as freshmen before Murray transferred. Kirk, though, he stayed in College Station, had a great three-year career before being drafted 47th overall in 2018. Was having a solid rookie campaign last year, but then broke his foot in week 13 and was shut down the rest of the way. Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Ain't no such thing as a loss. We take a win, Paul.
Second down, Murray sets to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. Pass the 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And no sweat. He puts it through. And we are tied here in the fourth. Couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all to score as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Murray again, second and 10. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Now after the holding call, here's second and 20. Now Murray throwing on second down. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. And they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game. Now Murray. He's going to let this one go deep. And that'll be incomplete. Now they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down. This defense looking impenetrable now. Three straight incompletions. They're giving him nowhere to go with the football. Maybe a little frustrated back there.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When you've missed on three straight, there's going to be some frustration. But now he's got to make sure that frustration is temporary, not lingering. Big throw coming up.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13.
Ready. 5-8.
Watch tight end.
Back to throw, Breeze. And he can't get it. taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. To throw is Breeze. And oh, they almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down. Two huge plays there down the stretch. The sack on second down. Now they force the incompletion. That's going to lead to a do-or-die fourth down.
And they look like they've got the confidence right now that no matter what gets thrown against them, whatever play gets run, they have the ability to shut it down. They're just brimming with it right now.
Gets it away, and I don't think Peterson will get a chance to touch this one. Angling for the sideline. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. To throw is Murray. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Here's Murray. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. To throw, Murray, and he hits Drake, and he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down, and whistles, and they take their final timeout with 7 seconds left. And everything right now rests on the right foot of Zane Gonzalez. This from 52, and this for the win. Kicks back out. Needed maybe a foot or two, but it's no good as it stands. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now. The ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. A pretty good-looking run there on first down. That'll go for 9 yards, just short of the line to gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. The last run got 9. That leaves them with 2nd and 1 yard. A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Ready.
On first down, Murray. Run. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Ready. 6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied.
Ready. Yellow waiting.
Six man. Check cross.
Check. Whip. Watch the whip. Shit.
Running with Kamara. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. 10 yards, good for the Saints, first down. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys, poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. So after the run by Kamara, now another 1st and 10.
Watch his flag. Under.
Check 52.
Hey, watch it.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. They've had some success here in overtime in this opening drive running the football. Right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think there's more water there and available to them.
Watch twist. Out.
Kill.
They'll run. This is Kamara. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. They'll be down to just 1 remaining as we step aside here in overtime. So a big play in this opening drive of overtime. Now looking at a 3rd and 3. Shotgun now for Breeze. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout. It'll be their 2nd and final timeout, remember, here in overtime. We'll be back. The kick by Lutz is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. They're able to put 3 on the board here on the opening drive of OT, and now up to their defense to try and see if they can hold this one.
I like how you framed it up, because obviously this game is not over, right? They go down and kick a field goal, then we head to sudden death. But if the defense can hold, take the ball away, turn it over on downs, this game's over.
A
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. The field goal would push it to sudden death. We just saw the field goal on the other end, but I don't think they are thinking field goal. At least not to start this drive, they're not thinking field goal.
Not at all, because your point is well taken. Yeah, kick the field goal, you push it to sudden death, but you're also kicking off and giving the other team the ball with a chance to kick a field goal and beat you. Get the touchdown, finish the game off. That has to be the mindset.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. The two straight incompletions, and now you got a situation. You're down three, so obviously you have two more downs to pick up the first. Back to the air on third, I assume.
I would assume, but you also have to think to yourself, they've got to pick up a first, right? They know they're down three. They have to match, otherwise this game is over. Maybe they approach it as two downs to pick up the first down. If you decide to run a draw or some type of a screen, something to try and pick up yardage and make it a manageable fourth down, that could be the call coming.
Throwing is Murray on third down. Going deep for Hopkins. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down. And here's your ball game. Down three in overtime, but they're going for this thing on fourth down. Murray and company going for it on fourth. Trying to lay one up deep. And this is going to be incomplete. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape. We were just treated to an absolute dandy in this one. A great finish in overtime with a long field goal. Everybody, including us, on the edge of their seats. Quite a game.
And it's rare that you get a game into overtime that it doesn't turn out to be a dandy, right? That's what we saw here. And just what you were talking about, a long field goal to win it. So definitely not a gimme. So there was tension all the way through until the ball went through the post.
But it did go through the post. Ice water was in his veins. So for the Saints, they close out this first half at a very solid 6-2. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, they fall two games under 500 now at 3-5. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Numbers going up. All these trophies, what do I need anymore for? Check the stats up. lifestyle. Different cities every week now. Every woman is now. What state prop you looking bleak now? I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true because you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kind of made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
S-T-R-O. Yeah.
How many of y'all came to win?
Oh, they asking my name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
It's
early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
No.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like
man,
I made with you. I've been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Making shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up. Never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please. Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tired. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field. Hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard. On the job, you can see that. On my head is real good. We don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, taste the beans.
What I do?
Lace up the shoes, taste the beans.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, taste the beans.
Yeah.
The beats, leave it in the street. Trace on the news.
What I do? Lace up my shoes, chase W's. Great colored coupes. Oh no, no, I can't be number two. MVP the league most valuable. They sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab the few. Can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, it's not no preseason. We seeking W's like Tupac used to throw up. Forget it, might as well forfeit, your team shouldn't even show up. What you wanna be when you grow up? They used to ask me. Naturally, I chose an athlete. Competition never matched me. We ain't go together, like camouflaging.